What's going on, Power Director peeps? Let's jump right off into this DVD menu disc authoring thing. You see, I got my video clips down in the timeline track. First thing I need to do is set up some chapters so that the DVD menu can be created. So I'm gonna go to the chapter room. When I click on chapter room, it creates chapter one, and then I have some selections here to set up my chapters. I can insert chapters at the start of each clip. I can insert chapters at fixed intervals, change the minutes. I can insert chapters evenly, or I can manually add chapters by simply going and placing my playhead where I'd like, clicking on the add a chapter button, and then I can remove the chapters. I can delete all the chapters, can do a lot of different things here. I'm gonna let Power Director do all the work for me because I'm a lazy son of a, okay? So I'm gonna make sure that I select the radio button next to insert chapter at the start of each clip, and then I'm gonna click on start. So now I have four chapters. It put it at the beginning of each clip like I asked it to do. A few things I can do. I can change the names of the chapters. I can just click on the chapter here and I can change the name of it. I'm gonna leave them as they are for now. Can also change the thumbnail. So I can drag my playhead. I can scrub the timeline to a position that I like the thumbnail to be. And let's say I like that better. Then I can click on this button here to set it as a thumbnail. When I click on it, you'll see at the top where I have this chapter, it changed it to where the playhead was at. So now that's the thumbnail. All right. So now that I have these set up the way I like, I can go ahead and click on the Create Disc button. Now it automatically adds a default disc, which is this Monopoly type deal that we got going on. So I want to make a few changes. The play button and the scenes button are fine. I don't want this to be called my video, so I'm going to highlight this and call it test menu. All right. So now it's called test menu. As I look at this, I can click on show chapters. It'll have all the chapters that I created a moment ago. I can edit the title, can actually set new chapters, and I can just get rid of this whole submenu. Now over here on the left, I have the import additional videos. So let's say I wanted to add some other videos that I already had created and they weren't part of the project and I didn't add them to the timeline. Now I want to add them. I can click on this button. And I can add whatever video I want to, really. So let's say I just added this intro. And then there's also this button here for importing projects. So if I click on this button, I can go to where my projects are. Mine are under documents. Yours might be somewhere else. And I can click on a project and click open. Now that project has been added. And just for the sake of fun, let's go ahead and add another video on here. Now what I also want to do is I want to add chapters to each one of these videos I added, because what they're going to create is a sub menu. Because when you add a video from here, it doesn't just create chapters, it creates sub menus. So you need to be aware of that. So each sub menu, I want it to have chapters. So I'm going to click on show chapters. It says there's only one chapter here. Well, let me change that. I'm going to click on set chapters. And now I can manually set a chapter here simply because it's just one video clip. So let's just say I added my chapters like that. Now I can click on create disk and go back here. All right, we're golden. So now I want to look at this menu structure that I have right now. So I'm going to click on menu structure. And right now it looks kind of jacked up, but the reason why is because this menu only has three chapters per submenu. So if you go over three, like with this one, it was four. It's going to make another submenu and then just have the one chapter there. Same thing with this one. It had three on it, made another submenu on another chapter. So I want to clean this up. So in order to do that, I have to select a different menu. So I'm going to go to menu preferences. And since I know that there's no more than four chapters per submenu that I created, I'm going to pick one here that has four chapters. I think this one will do the trick. This one actually has six chapters, it looks like. So I'm going to do apply to all pages. And now if I go back to my menu structure, it looks a lot cleaner now. And so each submenu is good to go. Now this thing's called test menu. So if I go to any one of these, I want to make sure that it's named correctly. It's not called my video. So I want to click on them and I'll give them the name that they should have. All right, now it looks like everything is beautiful in my world. So I like what I'm seeing here. So if I click on preview, we'll get a preview of the disk and how it's set up. So right now it's set up to play the first one. So let me hit stop so it'll go to the menu. Some people might like that music, but I don't. All right, it's all set up. It's good to go. I like how it's looking right now. A few options we got here. We got the background music. I said I did not like that background music. You have the option to set your own background music, or you could just remove the background music that's on it, or you can use Magic Music to place some music in it. I'm going to click on set background music. And when you do, you have the option to click on this button here to select the file. It open up File Explorer, and then you just go to where you want, where the music is that you want, and then you just click on open. I'm not going to add any music right now, so I'm going to click on cancel. Now you have the option to fade in, fade out. You can auto repeat. You can trim the music. As you do it, you can tell that the start, end, and duration times change down below. So you can change where it starts, change where it stops. And then I would apply it to all pages so that it's on all the menus and submenus. Right now I'm going to click on cancel. You have the option to add a intro video or what's called a first play video. So if you want something to play before the menu starts, like on a lot of the professional DVDs out there, you can click on this button to add a first play video. Click on it, go to the location on your computer where the video is, click on that video. And then you click on open. It'll bring it in. You can remove that video. You can preview it. All that good stuff. Then you have your playback mode. So this tells how the disc will act when it's put into a DVD player. So if you click on this button here, you have options. Right now it's start from the first title and play all titles sequentially. That's why it didn't start at the menu when I went to the preview. Then you have the option to start from the menu page. And then when you hit play, it'll play all of the titles. Start from the first title and play, just repeat them Some people wanted that option to just repeat them. And then if you want to, you can click on the menu button to go to the menu. And then just play the selected title only. That's good for like instructional DVDs. So if you just want to play chapter 1 and then go back to the menu, or play chapter 3 and go back to the menu, you can choose this type of option. Once you pick what you want, you just click OK. You can make it the default. You can make your menu time out after a certain amount of seconds. All that good stuff. So I'm going to click on OK. And now if I click on preview again, you'll see that first play video. So now that we got all that done, we can burn our disk. So we can burn a 2D disk or a 3D disk. I'm going to go to 2D disk. You select the type of disk that you want to do. A Blu-ray, AVC HD, a video CD, or a DVD. Select your recording format. This is DVD video, of course, because we selected DVD, widescreen. MPEG 2 is going to be the only option for a DVD because that's the best quality for a DVD. You can do high quality. Or smart fit, you got your sound, all that good stuff. You do Blu-ray disc, then of course you have your Blu-ray movie format. You got widescreen. You can choose between MPEG 2 and H.264. You got your 1920 by 1080 60i, and also 720 60p, 24p, all that good stuff. So you got all your options in there. You get the freaking routine. All right, people. Then when you're done, just click on burn in 2D or burn in 3D or whatever option you're doing.